One, two. Yes, hi colleagues. I am Alexander, C++ developer, work professionally with backend for online gaming, and I do frontend as hobby project, among other, contribute to this Sweden C++ website that Harald mentioned in React. And I recognize many of you and even work with many of you in same companies, even with several people from our today host NetInsight. And I, of course, recognize many of you from earlier meetups. And you probably remember that event at Game Developer Paradox, where Bjorn suggested us a book to borrow and to do a review. And because I like reading C++ books and I love sharing my opinion, I volunteered. So today I will do a review of 10 minutes and intend to give you enough information to decide if you want to read it too. This book was intended to be special for C++ community. It was intended as the book of C++ to give all developers the same understanding and knowledge base to develop on, because author noticed that many developers used C++ after this was 90s. And the reason for this was not lack of available information, in contrary, overflow of information, making it hard for normal developers to keep up and keep themselves up to date. So he wrote a short book to give overview to everyone, so everyone have time to read. And the author knows what he's talking about. It's Bjarne Straustrup. And the book he called A Tour of C++. And similar to a guided tour in a city, it does not teach you practical thing how to live in city. It's rather makes navigation easier, shows main point of attraction and wake up curiosity about certain areas. It shows all major features of basic of language itself and standard libraries. And I like that in difference to many C++ books that talks about what is new in C++, this one doesn't define increment, but a state, like Ansible would do. It defines state, what is C++ now, and it does not point out which features are just recently added and which existed since always. This is second edition, and it defines state of C++ 17. First edition defined C++ 14, and I looked up on internet without finding any confirmation of my guess that third edition will be for C++ 20. It's still just my guess. Author says that everyone can read it in just few hours. My experience that you find enough enjoyable information for at least 3 days. So you can have a whole sightseeing weekend in C++ world. And to continue traveling topic, this book is very suitable for reading during travel because it's quite compact and it does not have any runnable samples or exercises. So you can enjoy it without a computer. So it's very suitable to read during long flight or if you are trapped in a hotel, in airport hotel because flight is delayed, or if you care about environment, you can read it on train. So who would benefit of reading this book? I suggest 3 groups of people. First one, obviously, it's the target audience. The quote is from Straustrup.com. Yes, he aimed it to C++ developers who still had obsolete view of C++, who didn't notice it yet that C++ is now a much better tool than it was in the 90s. The second group are experts in other programming languages. they can move to C++ when they need to make those their products more performant. And the third group is C++ amateurs, meaning us, people who have C++ as leisure activity. And for us, it is like reading hometown's city guide to enjoy how nice city we live in or how awesome tool we use. And there is more. Each chapter in this book ends with a list of very specific advices how C++ should be used. Some of them just common sense, I'd say. Some of them I very agree with, they were relevant in my work. And I found few of them that before reading this book, I was certain that I should use C++ just contrary to this advice. And the thing is, even after reading this book, I'm not totally convinced that I was wrong. And I think many of you would find several advices that you are not agree either. And I think even we can, when everyone read the book, we can have a meetup and dedicate to topic which part we disagree with Bjarne Straustrup about C++. Probably off the record, for example, during our traditional summer break, like this coffee break that we have. Yes. So I also learned something. I mean, this book makes it obvious and like underline and put it very explicitly that C++ has important feature property that is zero cost expressive abstractions. And as we all know, there is no such thing as free lunch. Zero cost means in this case that zero cost in runtime. The cost is moved from runtime to compilation time by using templates that generally are underused. And I guilty also, I use STL, of course, but I don't create my own templates that I learned. And we can move a lot from runtime to compilation time. Good example of this was created by person that you many of you knows, who Jean, who works at King, the company famous with the game Candy Crush Saga. He created a whole game where both game loop and rendering performed in compilation time, and only putting the rendered frame into screen done in runtime. So it's practically zero time in runtime. And you can see, as Harald mentioned, his video on YouTube and the Sweden C++ YouTube channel. He also wrote a blog about it that I find more informative because it's easier to rewind the blog if you notion it that you missed something, because video just continue. If you miss something, you just not notice. And you can, of course, get the game from his GitHub account. So the key takeaway for me from this book was using templates for zero cost abstractions. So you can watch his presentation and explanation about moving load from runtime to compilation time on YouTube, read the detailed explanation, and you can get the code, and by compiling this game, you will also play the game. So finally, conclusion is enjoy the book, use templates, play the game. Any questions? Yes, please.
Did you hint at any of the statements that Straustrup made that you disagree with?
His question, if I want to mention exactly which question I speak.
Mention just one.
Well, no, I prefer to spar it to next coffee break, summer break, C++ coffee break, so we can discuss it thoroughly. Yes, please.
Did you enjoy reading it?
Yes, question was if I did enjoy reading it. Yes, absolutely, otherwise I wouldn't recommend it to everyone, yes.
Said that it was very non-technical, but do you think that it was too non-technical to really understand things, or do you think it was a good level?
Yes, question was if it was too non-technical to understand things. Yes, you could not learn C++ programming from it, and you definitely couldn't learn programming if you knew for programming. So it rather shows what C++ has to offer, but it does not teach how to use it. So it's rather like if you would reading like something about black holes in a newspaper or something. So you have to dig further yourself and do research. Yes, it doesn't teach anything. Yes, please.
What can you say about Bjarne's style of writing?
Yes, the question was about Bjarne's style of writing. Well, I enjoyed the book, so I don't know. I didn't notice it anything special. It was fine. Yes. So finally, bottom line, I liked it. So.